Hello everybody, welcome to the Java example section. In this section, I'm going to set up a program to evaluate this branch sales performance. So my idea is like this. I would like to load the yearly sales performance of three branches from a text file. And I'm going to show you the format of the text file very soon. After that, I can evaluate the yearly sales amount for all the branches together with the quarterly sales performance for each branch. Let us see the implementation. So I would like to show you the text file first. Okay, the text file is called branch sales.txt and it is stored in the same folder as my workspace for the current project. When I click on it, I will see the format like this. So I have three lines which represent the performance of the three branches. So all these values would represent the sales performance in a certain quarter for a certain branch. So for branch one, the quarter one value would be equal to this amount. And for branch one, the sales performance for the second quarter in a year would be this amount, so on and so forth. So altogether, I would have 12 pieces of information for the three branches. Okay, so when I want to calculate the yearly sum, I would simply add up all these 12 numbers. And when I want to set up the program to evaluate the quarterly sales performance, I would simply sum up the first column values to represent the total sales performance for all three branches in the first quarter. Okay, so let us see how I can do it. Because I'm going to load some text file, I need to make use of the file class. Okay, this is the file class. I have to import it first. I also need to import the scanner class because I need it to accept the user input as well as the file input. Okay, let us start the main method. Because it is possible that the file that I'm going to load is not present in my current folder, I need to handle the exception by typing throws exception after the declaration of the main method. Okay, and then I can create a scanner object that is going to accept the user input of the file name. Okay, the constructor of the scanner object would be system.in, being the actual parameter of the constructor. The reason is that I'm going to accept the user input. Now I give a prompt to the user. Okay, now I create a scanner object whose reference variable is called file name, and it is going to accept the file name from the user by using the next line method. After accepting the user input, I can close the scanner object. Okay, this is a string data type. Okay. And then I can create a file object. Okay, this file object is having the actual parameter as follows. I use the file name obtained from the user input as the actual parameter of the file constructor. Okay. And I will have a file object whose reference variable is called my file. I need to read the text file so I can reuse the scan reference variable pertaining to the previous scanner object that is already closed. And I equate this reference variable to the new scanner object whose actual parameter is my file. That means I'm going to read the file by using the scanner object. Now I set up the variable called Alysom, which is going to find out the total sales performances for all the branches in the particular year shown on my text file. I would initialize it to be 0 at the beginning. Then I can set up some of the variables to remember the quarterly sales performance. I can make use of an array of 4 elements because 1 year would have 4 quarters. So this is an array of double primitives that would have 4 elements. And I don't need to initialize each of the elements in this array to be 0. Why? Because it is already initialized to be 0 by default. Now I can do the real calculation. I'm going to have a variable called count, which is going to count the number of values processed. Okay, so I have 12 values, and this count variable is going to keep track of the current value being processed. While the hasNextTuple method returns true, I can do the extraction of data from the text file. Okay, the nextTuple method is going to obtain the number from a text file if the hasNextTuple method returns true. And I have a local variable called sales for the while loop that is going to store the value obtained from the text file one by one. Okay, I can calculate the yearly sum by simply adding all the values obtained from the text file. Now I can handle the situation to evaluate the quarterly sum. Okay, my count variable is initialized to be 0. So when I make use of the count modulo 4 evaluation, I'm going to have 0, 1, 2, or 3 as the answer. That means I can make use of this remainder evaluation to represent the quarter of a particular sales amount. So if it is quarter 0, it means that I'm going to handle the value from the first column of my data file. And if the remainder is equal to 1, I'm going to handle the sum of the values coming from the second column, so on and so forth. Okay. In this case, I can simply add up all the sales amount for the particular quarter in the corresponding element of the quarterly sum array. Okay. After evaluating the yearly sum and the quarterly sum, I need to increase the count variable by 1 in order to process another value coming from the data file. Okay. When I set up count to be a value which is 1 larger than the original value, I'm going to change the quarter that I'm going to handle for the next value. Okay. And after processing the text file, I can close the scanner object. Okay. I can print out the yearly sum which is obtained from adding up all the values in the text file. Okay, by using a for loop, I can print out the quarterly sum for each quarter, okay? So let me try to run it now. Okay, I need to input the file name, which is simply that one. Okay, let me press enter. When I press enter, I will be able to find out the total yearly sum for all the branches, which is equal to this amount. And when we refer to the text file again, this value is simply equal to the sum of all the 12 numbers coming from the text file, okay? And there are so many trailing zeros because usually a floating point number in Java might not be able to be represented exactly. In this case, I would see a lot of zeros at the end. So, in principle, the sum of all these 12 numbers would be simply equal to this amount only. And the remaining part of this number comes from the position error when we represent some kind of floating point numbers in Java. Okay. And what's the meaning of the four numbers below? Each number would simply be equal to the sum of the corresponding column in my text file. So the first number would come from the sum of the three numbers from my first column of the text file, and the second number would come from the sum of the numbers in the second column of my text file, so on and so forth. Okay, let me try to run that again to see the situation of the exception. I can simply set up a new text file that is not present. Okay, when I refer to my workspace folder, there is no such file name as abc.txt. When I click press enter, I would be able to handle the exception because I have explicitly thrown the exception, okay, by putting this command after the main method declaration. Okay. So this is the situation when the file is not existent in the workspace folder. I would have the file not found exception. Okay. So this completes the program that returns the yearly sales amount and the quarterly sales amount. My code is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the best or the most efficient approach to the problem. If you can suggest any idea to improve my code, please do so on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.